Recording.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Impactful Legacy podcast. And I'm so grateful that you're rejoining or catching a glimpse of me again or the show again. So anyway, I'm so grateful that you're all here. And I'd like to introduce to you my special guest is Laurie. And I've known Laurie actually for a little bit. We met at the Kindness Launch in Long Beach, but oh my gosh, a long time ago. It seems like forever. Right, Laurie? So right. Laurie, why don't you just introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about what you're doing and how'd you get started doing what you're doing?
Okay, well, I'm Laurie Ellis-Young, and I have an organization called Breathe the Change. And I also have a nonprofit called Breath Logic. And I have a lot of passions in life, but it's all seems to revolve back to the breath, mm-hmm. as breath is life. And that's what fuels, you know, whatever we do in life. So to just start with how I first became interested in breath was at 14 years old, somehow in a small town in South Dakota, I got a book on yoga, and it changed my life, actually. Mm-hmm. It opened my life, mm-hmm. and it made me aware that actions can be coordinated with breath, mm-hmm. you know, yoga,
yeah,
postures. And so I became aware of my breath, which I don't think I was ever really aware that I was breathing before.
Oh, interesting. Well, I think, you know, at 14, that's pretty young to learn about yoga and breathing.
Yeah. And then when I was almost 30, I went on my first trek, first of several dozen treks in the Himalayas and the Andes. Mm-hmm. And that's when I really learned about the power of breath. Stamina, you know, physical stamina, but mental, emotional, spiritual. And I became impassioned with how breath helps us to take the next step we need to make in life, whether it's up a mountain, mm-hmm. or whether it's after running after your child, or, you know, wherever it may be. And I searched out many different types of teachers, mm-hmm. of breath, and then moved from a focus on yoga, the postures, the asanas, to working with people with breath. Mm-hmm. Met my husband late in life. He was a post-conflict psychologist. We met in Guatemala. And he brought me to some very interesting places like Kosovo and Cambodia, mm-hmm. and the Middle East, and most recently, Ukraine. Mm-hmm. So together we have been able to work with very diverse populations on five different continents, and see how breath really makes a difference in people's lives, mm-hmm. dealing with trauma, PTSD, secondary trauma, and not just that, but helping to live a more fulfilled life, mm-hmm. and have greater well-being, health and well-being overall. So that's a synopsis.
Yeah, as we were when we were talking before we started recording this, it's sort of like, you know, breath, you're breathing, that brings you into more consciousness, your God source or your angels. You could do that too, right? I've just recently decided to take up automatic writing. So the breath helps you get connected to that source, right? And it's also the grounding force, right? You have to have. When you're breathing, like if you're not breathing, you're dead.
Absolutely.
So, but being conscious about your breath, right?
Right. And so when you're unconscious, you know, so often it's the reptilian brain, the back of our brain, that is in charge. And so we're either sometimes not breathing and we're in a freeze mode, or we're breathing really shallowly or fast, yeah. and we're in a state of mild to severe fight or flight or anxiety. Mm. And when we become conscious, we move to activating our prefrontal cortex, which it is all about, to me, executive functions, how we really want to act and react and be in life.
Mm-hmm.
So consciousness and breath is just absolutely intertwined.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, I could see that being more conscious of how we're breathing will tell us basically, if we're aware, you know, where we are right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So would you be willing to do a little breath work with us to show us what you do and how it works?
Sure. Yeah, you know, it just came up right away this moment, is a simple breath awareness technique with movement with the hands.
Okay.
So I invite you to close your eyes.
Okay.
Allow your eyes to close and to take a couple moments to really soften your eyes and to smile to your eyes, bringing a gentle smile to your face. It tells our brain that we're safe, begins to soothe the nervous system, and to begin watching your breath. First, the knowledge of whether you are inhaling or whether you are exhaling. Something we are so seldom aware of, and it starts to create these wonderful neural pathways in the brain that help to bring greater calm, concentration, focus to our lives. And now to go a little bit deeper with this, bring your awareness to really feeling what is happening with the inhale and the exhale. Where you feel it in your body, how you feel it, how they flow from one to the other. And to notice the energetics of the taking in of the inhale and the letting go of the exhale. And to become aware of anything that you would like to let go of in your life that keeps you from taking in a greater sense of peace and calm. Maybe it's a physical pain. Maybe it's worry. Whatever it may be. And we're going to continue this breath of telling yourself as you inhale, I breathe in peace. As I exhale, I breathe out pain, or I breathe out cares, or I breathe out worries, whatever it is for you. And we're going to begin to bring hand motions into the movements of the breath. With the hands, palms up, the inhale lifts, and the exhale lowers. So a greater sense of taking in that sense of peace, calm, serenity, and letting go of whatever it is that does not contribute to that sense. And allowing the movements, the raising of the hands, the letting go of the hands, to be completely guided by your breath. The taking in of the inhale lifts, the letting go of the exhale lowers. So it's an effortless movement. Continuing for just a couple more breaths. And then for the next two breaths, inhaling peace and exhaling peace as a gift to the world. Taking in peace, letting go peace, giving out peace. There's a sense of metta, loving kindness meditation of wishing peace for all beings. And then taking in a breath, holding it a moment, just savoring, letting go with a sigh. And then taking your time to allow your eyes to open. I always love when people first open their eyes. There's just such a change. A change. How did that feel for you, Mary?
Well, it was interesting to note that when I went into the breathing exercise of how much shallow breathing I was actually breathing. So, and then towards the end, it was like, yeah, opening it up so I could feel more open in my energy. So yeah, it was very good. Interesting. Thank you.
You know, the wonderful thing about just simple breath awareness, the knowing whether you're inhaling or exhaling, which Thich Nhat Hanh says is the most important information we can ever go to during the day. Yeah. Are you inhaling? Are you exhaling? Are you taking in? Are you letting go? Mm-hmm. What are you taking in? What are you letting go? That's right. Life. So when you do that, it just naturally deepens your breath. Mm-hmm. So you get more oxygen, you get more life force flowing. And then what was it like when you brought the hand movements in?
It was good because it was just the motion of lifting myself up and then, you know, kind of letting it go down. I don't know if you saw it on the screen, but I was doing it, but it was, you know, I wasn't up here. But, you know, kind of very interesting as far as, you know, doing all that. And so it sort of like gave my body permission to let it go.
Yes.
It and let it go. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
And then with the movements of the hands then and the breath directing the movements, your mind gets to relax a little bit more because it's not your mind that's doing it. It's your breath.
Right.
So there's a little more of a respite of, you know, our chaotic thoughts that we're normally thinking.
Right.
And then also it's the hand movement, something else to focus on. Deepens concentration. So even though that was just seemed like just a little thing that we were doing, it's actually a very powerful practice.
Right Yeah. I guess I could feel that because it was like I said, I could feel the energy of my energy rising up and then you know, so I didn't want to feel like I'm pushing my energy down, but yeah, it was very. And like you say, it's a simple little exercise we could do throughout the day. Like if we're becoming anxious or there's something not going well in our day, we could just take that minute or two to do that, to really just kind of clear up the space, you know? Yeah, so cool. So tell us a little bit about, I know you shared already how you got started and what you're teaching now. So what programs are you running now? You briefly shared before, so maybe you can tell our audience what kind of programs you run and who do you like to work with?
Okay, well, because Ukraine was invaded about a month ago and my husband and I lived over 4 years in Ukraine, we've been very focused on that. And so we have done some programs called Change Your Breath, Change Your Life. And we have offered them with much of the proceeds going to different programs in Ukraine.
Mm-hmm.
And since we have a number of friends that are still in Ukraine and that also are outside of Ukraine as refugees in other places in Europe and also in the States and Canada,
mm-hmm.
is we are realizing from some different programs, Care for Self and Care for Ukraine, mm-hmm. that we've done, that one dear friend whose story is just harrowing.
Mm-hmm.
I won't go into it now, but she is safe with one daughter, her youngest daughter, and her two oldest daughters have refused to leave Ukraine.
Mm.
They are 19 and 21, and they are working for the resistance in Western Ukraine. So that's something that has been hard for her to deal with, to leave her daughters behind and also leave her mother-in-law behind, who's in her 80s, mm-hmm. and refused to leave. Mm. But yet she had to think of her youngest daughter. So that's just one story. And she was on the call with the Care for Self, Care for Ukraine that we did, an hour and a half program, mm-hmm. Having breakout sessions to talk and mm-hmm. have people be able to deal with, you know, their direct traumas around Ukraine, and then also secondary traumas of just watching the images on TV mm-hmm. and knowing what is happening. And our friend Natalia, who has had this 1 month of a process of fleeing, she said after the program, this is the first time since before the invasion that I have been able to feel any relaxation.
Mm.
So we realize mm-hmm. that, you know, just a short period even can mm-hmm. help people to find a place of safety inside, a place of sanctuary. I mean, that's one of the greatest gifts that mm-hmm. the breath gives us. So we are starting a program where it is going to be your daily blips. And what Breathologic is about and Breathe a Change is sharing breath literacy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, think of all the other literacies that we know, you know, it's computer and phone literacy and all kinds of literacies. Have you ever thought of breath literacy?
No.
Which is, it's a foundation for all other literacies. So we have something called BLIPS, which stands for Breath Literacies Instant Power Practices.
Mm.
It's like what we just did, just even a smile. Is a blip. Yeah. So there are practices that you can do in a blip of time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they can take even just a few moments or longer, like what we did.
Right.
And so we are going to be offering daily 5 to 10 minutes or longer. You know, this is going to be a pilot program at first. We'll see how long people want. Maybe we'll do 15 minutes and if people can only come for 5, they come for 5 and then leave.
Yeah.
But of your daily blips so that people can tune in. We found out that it's not recorded blips that people want to watch.
Mm-hmm.
It's the live. Right. So that connection of breathing together,
mm-hmm.
breathing together in purposeful presence.
Right.
You know, peaceful pause.
Right.
And so we're going to be rolling that out in the next week.
Okay.
And we have people working on this so that there will be people in the States, all over the States, that will be joining. People in Ukraine, people in Romania and Poland and Canada and in other places, Greece. So it's going to be a global breathe together.
Okay, great. And so you will have sent that information so I can put it below this.
Oh, please. Video. Oh, yes.
And so that we can get the message out for you as well. Yeah, absolutely. No, it's amazing what breath can do, right? And like you're saying, the literacy of just teaching somebody how to breathe consciously versus, you know, just unconscious, you know, it's just everyday breathing, but you're not really aware of how you're breathing. Right. Yeah. So who do you normally like to work with or teach about breathing?
Oh, wow.
I know we can say everybody, but you know, not everybody is interested, right?
You know, Mari-Lyn, when I first started working with breath, which was over 30 years ago, I used to have to really convince people.
Yeah.
It's like, why would you think about your breath? But now people are hungry for it and wanting it. And when I first started writing a book about breath, when I first thought about writing a book, I was like, who would read that? And there were hardly any books on breath out there, but now there are lots of books on breath. Yeah. And I actually, my husband and I just published a book, Breath is Life.
Okay.
We wrote most of it while we were in Ukraine. And you ask about who we like to work with. I mentioned that we have worked with populations, diverse populations on five continents. Mm-hmm. We've worked with kids from pre-K all the way up through post-grad. Mm-hmm. Elders in nursing homes and assisted living. My husband, who's a psychologist, has worked with, you know, the gamut. I've worked with girls rescued from brothels in Cambodia, street children, homeless. We worked in a project outside Guatemala City for 2 years, people living in a new community to help them move from the consciousness of poverty, of living in the most dire slums outside Guatemala City, to moving into a place where there's safety and homes that sewage doesn't run through, you know, during the rainy season. So as I say, like, we've loved working with every different type of population, but I would say it's people that feel committed to caring about their well-being.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a kindness inside out. I mean, you know, we met at the kindness, and there were so many amazing people there that were focusing on kindness in so many different ways. It was just so uplifting.
Mm-hmm.
And what Breath Logic was doing there was focusing first on kindness inside out.
Right.
We have to be kind to ourselves.
Oh yeah,
absolutely. Love ourselves. Find peace within before we go out and take it out into the world.
Right.
Otherwise, how can we sustain?
Right.
What we do for others if we don't do it for ourselves? So,
right.
You name a population, and you know, I think we would love to work with them. It's who comes, who's in front of us, you know, and right now it's the people in Ukraine and also people dealing with PTSD and secondary trauma, whether it be from COVID, whether it be from losing a family member.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I can see that, how the breath work really would support somebody who is in grief or trauma in that regard. Absolutely. So I loved our conversation so far. So can you maybe just give some, do you have a tip or something? You already shared your gift already, but do you have any tips or suggestions for people to start breathing or take your programs, or, you know, yeah, just to share some tips about how people can get started to be educated about their breath. That's mm-hmm. really what I'm trying to say.
Well, you know, our book.
Yeah.
Our book.
Breath, and where do we get the book?
It's on Amazon. You can also get it through our website,
okay.
breathlogic.org. And honestly, it's taking in and letting go. Mm. How to live well, love well, be well. And we have had just some wonderful, wonderful feedback about the book, that it is life-changing. Mm-hmm. And it shares so many different ways of how to breathe better as a life practice. Mm-hmm. How do we breathe optimally, mm-hmm. moment by moment, breath by breath? And then how do we breathe throughout situations all throughout life? Mm-hmm. So it's like a master course on breath literacy. And it is, both of us, George shares the neuroscience. He came to breath because of neuroscience and studies and academia. And yeah. I came because of trekking and yoga. And actually, he also came because he was a scuba diver, mm-hmm. and realized that when he scuba dived is when he felt so relaxed, so focused, so calm. It was the work with the breath.
Yeah.
And the nervous system. You know, he's just so impassioned with working with the nervous system, and that's what the breath works with. So I would say, you know, that book to me is my legacy, because yeah. I know you asked about
yeah, what legacy. Your legacy is.
Yeah. Legacy. It's our legacy to living a more fulfilled life in every way possible,
just through our breath.
And also, check Breath Logic out. We have free tutorials, breathlogic.org. We have free tutorials. We will be having the information about your daily blips, mm-hmm. and many other things that are coming up. Very exciting retreats, workshops.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Very good.
And
very
we
good.
Love co-creating with people, Mari-Lyn. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's like, you know, connecting with you is so wonderful. Mm-hmm. The work that you are doing.
Yeah. Yeah. I can see how that's going to help me. I have a resource now to give people when they need that, right? Mm-hmm. To help them. So I can see that working well mm-hmm. together. Yeah. Anyway, great. Do you have any final thoughts before we close out?
Final thoughts.
Just for now. I'm sure we'll be talking again, but
I think it's again to go back to how we started with talking about meeting at the World Kindness, bringing World Kindness, the organization, to the initial opening in the United States, is to the world right now is in a place in mm-hmm. so many ways. I mean, physical, but also metaphorically speaking,
yeah.
where we need kindness. We need kindness. We need kindness for ourselves, and just taking a moment to go inside and notice if you're inhaling, notice if you're exhaling, consciously breathe in peace, consciously breathe out whatever is impeding that peace, mm-hmm. is an act of kindness that we take out. Then we're not so likely to be irritated or mm-hmm. frustrated. So we have more kind interactions with people close to us, and we take it out into the world. There is no way to peace.
Right.
Peace is the way that's attributed to so many great peacemakers. So I'll end with that. That's my last thought.
Okay, great. Thank you so
it
much.
It all comes Lori. Back to peace, doesn't it? Peace and kindness.
Yeah, back to peace, kindness, and love. That's sort of mm-hmm. my thing too. Yeah. Great. Thank you very much, Laurie, for being on the show today. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Mari-Lyn, for having me.
Yeah. I love your legacy. It's great. And then closing, just be kind to each other. That's all we have, is just be kind to ourselves and so that we can be kind to others. So thank you for joining us today. And if you haven't subscribed to the show yet, be sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the dinger, and you'll be notified when the next video goes up, our next show. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much. Thank you.